An aerial view of San Francisco at dusk. A man with white hair and a beard addresses the camera. A graphic reads, Bryan Bashin, CEO, LightHouse for the Blind. A woman with shoulder-length blonde hair sits beside Bryan and addresses the camera. A graphic reads, Sheri, Albers, Community Outreach Coordinator, LightHouse for the Blind.
I'm Bryan Bashin. I'm CEO of LightHouse for the Blind in San Francisco. I've been blind my whole adult life.
My name is Sheri Albers, and I am the Community Outreach Coordinator for LightHouse for the Blind in San Francisco. So I grew up with an eye disease that was degenerative, losing my vision slowly over my life. But I didn't have any services. I didn't know any resources.
Bryan and Sheri addressed the camera.
My purpose is to make sure that other blind people who are newly blind or just learning to deal with blindness have the same opportunities so that they can have the life they want.
We do face discrimination. We face low expectations from society, even within our own families.
We will not put up with the prejudices and passivity of the past. We want to bring into a future where every human being, no matter what their level of eyesight, is cherished, and every human being has a chance to reach their potential. And so when I think about Waymo autonomous vehicles, I think about this is humanistic technology. The chance to have autonomy in vehicles and everywhere else is a mean to get us to where we want to go, which is living in the world, being part of the world. It's not just about going to a place. It's about having possession of your own life. And this is what ultimately, in the highest aspect of technology, it serves human beings and human needs.
Bryan and Sheri carry white canes and stand on the side of a residential street. A white Waymo autonomous vehicle approaches and stops in front of them. Bryan eases himself into the back seat of the vehicle. Sheri and Bryan sit in the back seat. The car begins to drive down the street. The car drives through an intersection.
It's approaching. It's slowly approaching. Oh, Bryan, this is it. Oh my gosh, this is it. It's beautiful.
Are you ready to start the ride?
I think I'm ready.
Here we go.
Okay.
Wow, you know, it started with a good acceleration.
It did. No hesitation at all.
Like it was confident.
Uh-huh.
Sheri and Bryan sit in the back seat of the car and look out the windows. Video clips showing the streets, traffic, and the car driving in the city. Bryan addresses the camera. The car pulls over to the side of the road. Sheri and Bryan use their white canes to enter a restaurant. Cars drive past a building on the corner. A sign on the side of the building reads, 21st Amendment Brewery Cafe. A bartender fills pint glasses with beer and delivers them. Sheri, Bryan, and their coworker sit at a table and hold up their beer glasses.
The thousands of people who are connected to LightHouse have a common need, which is autonomy. Go where they want, when they want, with as little inconvenience to others as possible. This is exactly a tool for that. The ability to just go anywhere.
To have been able to experience the exhilaration of riding in an autonomous vehicle today as blind people, oh my goodness. I mean, it is just inexplicable joy.
Sheri and Bryan address the camera. Sheri tilts her head back and laughs. A black Labrador guide dog lies on the floor and looks around. Sheri, Bryan, and their coworker sit at the table and talk. Text on screen, let's talk autonomous driving. Waymo logo. LightHouse for the Blind and Visually Impaired logo.
It is independence and freedom.
Autonomous vehicles and Waymo are part of the future we want to bring into existence.